definitely is the energy, because of what we work on and the energy that coming through the keyboard, through the screens and everything. That's why we have the taweez on our body. We make sure that you keep wudu at all times. Wudu is not only for salah, wudu is at every moment a shield, is the armor for the believers. And this world is a big battle zone. So when we're going to go out from this house or in the house, wherever we are, we're continuously in wudu. You have your taweez, you have your wudu, you have your sunnah, you have everything, you're washing, and when you face your work, alhamdulillah, same thing. And then that same characteristic, and if you have a desk and they don't mind, you have pictures of the shaykh for the maddad support and to keep any type of negativity away, you put on your computer screen the taweezes. So you take a taweez, you take a photo of it, put it as a screensaver, and that should be on the computer so that not these bad things are coming through the screen and just looking at the screen and being inspired towards every type of badness and negativity. You're in a full battle with energy. And how you fortify yourself, how you believe and how you conduct yourself is then our salvation, because this is our training. All our people are heavily involved in posting and production and all sorts of activities. So they're all fortifying themselves with their wudu, their taweez, their practices, and that don't ever sit at the computer without wudu, and don't ever lose your state of wudu without refreshing your wudu. So it's not, oh, I just do that for salah. No, at every moment you're going to be under attack. And you may not feel it if you're a person who doesn't feel, but then you may start to have an energy come, and because you can't feel it, you begin to have different sicknesses and difficulties. So when you feel the energy coming, they're coming all over your body. And if they stay there without wudu, they're entering into the system. So it can be many, many leg issues, back issues, feet issues, everything. So it's a way of life, inshaAllah. Just madad is a simple word, just madad, visualize your shaykh, ask to be present with me that something is not right, madad. A'udhu billahi min shaitan, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, madad, madad. And you make your connection. If you have your phone in your hand, you should have on the notes section of your phone, then madad already there. Or your app, if you have the app on your phone, it's already there, it's at your finger. So how could it not be away or not near us? I can make a shortened version when I'm just madad to the shaykh and asking for the connection of difficulty. But if it's an intensely negative event is happening, then you open up and you can read the madad and asking for the nazar of the shaykhs. And even by pronouncing it out loud, you're bringing an energy into that room and into that environment that would be necessary for people who are having a very bad experience. So the names of holy people bring a mercy and a rahmah. And also when you mention the names of the shaykh, it's like a bell in their souls, those whom passed, it's like a bell in the heavens going off for them, somebody has mentioned your name. Immediately the nazar of those soul of those awliya are upon those people, watching them and seeing what their difficulty is. And that's when Allah Azzawajal, ittaqullah wa kunu ma'a sadiqeen. Means all our teachings are like a tasbih. When Allah says, I don't care for this physical world like the weight of a mosquito, so then what does Allah mean? Have taqwa and keep the company of sadiqeen. Is Allah talking about physical company only? Or be with them at all times? Their soul is most important, and Allah cares the most for your soul, not the physicality. So it means then these words of Qur'an are above the physical world and for the malakut and the world of light. Well, keep the company of sadiqeen, means in your soul and in your being be surrounded by these holy souls. InshaAllah there be a blessing and a protection for the believers. Yeah, again, that's the whole concept of the energy, right? You have to have the wudu, you have to have the ta'weez, you have to make all the du'as. And du'a ayatul kursi, get the ayatul kursi ta'weez, put it in your house, put it on your being if you feel that you're having these types of difficulty, and they should be all around the house. And then you keep reciting du'a ayatul kursi and asking for the madad of the shaykhs and Malik al-Khandiyas, the khadim of this ayatul sharif. Means the servant that guards the reality and the power of that du'a, and asking for his madad, asking to connect with the shaykhs and that his nazar be upon you and that to begin to take these difficulties away inshaAllah. And then support and give charity and do your madad and your meditation, and these things should go. That's when there are nations that that quote that, and they get people to come out on the street and fight and argue. Amr bi ma'ruf wa nahy an munkar. Yeah. Yes, that to stand up against oppression, go out in the streets and protest. But alhamdulillah, Mawlana Shaykh teaching that before you can activate ayatul kareem, it has to be on you. So you have to have activated that reality upon ourselves that the greatest oppressor is myself, and that I'm not reaching what Allah wanted, I'm not listening to what Allah wanted. So the greatest oppressor is myself, my nafs and my shaitan that are all partners against what Allah wants from me. So before I try to apply that to the outer world, tariqah comes and says, oh, first apply everything to yourself. If you were able to fight yourself, the oppression you put upon yourself and your loved ones, then you have the right to now go out and deal with the world. But the people now, they're themselves immense oppressors and then now trying to take the rights of people. So you see a whole bunch of like white guys in suits talking about Muslim women's rights. Are you kidding me? These are merchants of death, and you think they're worried about the rights of Muslim women? And why they're following Islamic law and hijab? What are they, are doing the nahi wa munkar? No. So you see the hypocrisy of these people, and who's talking, and they're taking the rights of people, and them themselves are criminals. So no, what Allah intended for everything is that first fix yourself. When you fix yourself and you fought yourself and you fought your own devils and demons, and you find yourself submitting to Allah, Allah opens for you a hikmah that worry about yourself. And if you can fix yourself, start to fix the loved ones that you have in your life. And that's enough. Don't worry about the condition of mankind, because Allah has put an ocean of darkness upon people. This is not the time to go out and protest. This is a time in which Allah said, injustice would fill the earth. So why are they gathering in tens of millions of people on the street? Is injustice, oh okay, you finally understood that Sayyidina Mahdi is coming and you're protesting what? There's injustice? We already knew that. You're supposed to stay quiet because injustice will start killing and slaughtering everyone. Not to be on the street for somebody's chair and position, nobody cares about that chair and position. Everyone stay home, cry that there's injustice, make your connection. Clean the oppression within ourselves until we begin to witness the divine and the divine lights within the self, and then alhamdulillah, Allah said, I don't change a condition of a people until they change themselves. But nobody wants to change themselves, they want to change a condition. I want to change the nation. Why are you worried about the nation? Change yourself. If you change yourself, Allah will change the nation. And if everybody changed themselves, then Allah changed the nation. When nobody wants to change themselves but they're only interested in the nation, means everyone's looking out and not looking in. And that's the danger, tariqah comes, and that's the safeguard in these difficulties. That, you know, great gift that Allah give to tariqah people is that when you learn from these shaykhs, you're going to avoid many, many calamities. You're stepping out into a horrific tornado or calamity for what? You're supposed to be at home fixing yourself and avoiding every type of fitna, because most definitely immense oppressions are going to enter onto the earth that is a sign of the arrival of Sayyidina Mahdi salam. It's not that you go and protest and you're going to reverse Allah's judgment. So you don't know what time it is. If you don't know what time it is, you're always doing the wrong thing. So people have to get on board and understand this is a very bad time and they're waiting for the arrival of Sayyidina Mahdi salam. Stay home and build yourself and hope Allah saves you. Never on the streets, you're not going to change anything. Is a sign of oppression is actually the sign of the arrival of Sayyidina Mahdi salam, inshaAllah.
A Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Mirahmadi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com.
Yeah, alhamdulillah, the lot of red moons coming lately. So these are signs that things are happening and that the love and the salawats on Sayyidina Muhammad and keeping that love for Prophet good character and good adab, that Allah from whatever goodness are in these tajallis to dress us in these tajallis. And whatever azab is coming to safeguard us from these azab. That's why these talks came tonight about support. Don't put off a good deed today and say, I'll do tomorrow, because you don't know what's coming for you tomorrow. Any good deed. Say, I want to give something for the food, I want to do something for the mawlid, do it next week. No, because you don't know what type of difficulty is coming next week, do it today. Do it the minute your heart was pushed with that thought, and that's our protection, that's the way Allah dress us and bless us. Those people whom have tafakkur and contemplation, the angels inspire them. Sell your wallet, right? You think Allah is not understanding what their people are doing with these crypto coins? And if you're vested somewhere or something going to cause a difficulty for you and you're somebody whom believes and practices, they immediately inspire you, sell that right away. Something difficult is coming. So it means Allah is everywhere, it's not just only in the masjid, Allah is in you and closer to your existence than you can imagine. So every practice is a safeguard, from a safeguard from every single direction. Whether you're going to be attacked through your food, where you're going to be attacked through your work, where you're going to be attacked in your meditation, where you're going to be attacked through your finance. Wherever this Dajjal is moving his energy, Allah is right there with you. So when you practice and you open your heart for inspiration, the inspiration comes for everything. How to safeguard every issue, because the shaykhs are receiving their communication on everything. We said, described before, they may bring an image of a child up and they know that that image means start to pray for them. So it means this system of communication is beyond imagination. It just requires the heart to be fine-tuned and opened and the practices to be understood. The power is in the stone. So the stone is the secret of the ring. The cane is for grounding, that it takes from my hand whatever energy is coming to me and it has to ground. It's the third prong. My two legs are using the energy source and we're going to ground with the cane. So whatever energy is coming, then the positive is coming and then you're pushing out the negative through the grounding. So the asa has its reality of grounding energy. Allah explained about Sayyidina Musa alayhis-salam, that when the most fierce magic is the pharaonic magic, and that's why they call pharaonic bloodlines. They're on this earth now and these are these secret societies, their bloodline and the spiritual beings attached to them are from those times and their magic is most fierce on this earth. But what Allah gave for us is that the cane of Sayyidina Musa salam ate their magic. And we know that that cane from Sayyidina Muhammad salam, because every sunnah is in the hand of Rasulullah. Only one Rasulullah is Sayyidina Muhammad salam, that everyone else is inheriting from that reality. So he took the cane of Prophet salam, and they turned it into a dragon, a real angelic dragon, and ate their magic. And they witnessed and saw that this is not magic, this is a creature we don't understand, this is from the heavens. And they went into sujood and accepted that reality. So the asa is an asa and it has immense reality of reviving the sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So then you take a tree, you cut a nice branch and then you clean it and you have mashallah asa. And you read upon it, إِلَى شَرَفَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَعَلَى أَصْحَابِ الْكِرَامِ, all the way through the du'a, إِنْ فِي بَرَكَاتِ السُنَّةِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, Ya Rabbi, energize my asa please. If you don't have the means to get an asa, make an asa, it's just a tree branch. In this barakah and these blessings that Allah dress you and bless you inshaAllah, take the link and share it. But when we put our teachings into our own mouth and put it out, we can be responsible for errors. And then trying to follow up and answer causes big problems because then they start to say things that are, well, who said that? But when you share the link and you share exactly what was taught and what came out, then let them contact, help me if they have an issue with the article. With all the Qur'anic verses and hadith that will be sort of published, then let the shaykhs deal with somebody who doesn't like what's being taught. But when we take into our own hand and start to recite things or enter into conversations, then we're in difficulty. If we say it wrong, we get heated and we start to spit out other information. So that's what we found in our own life always, was just take the information, disseminate, and you got your reward. And you put a little highlight, you send a group, because everyone's now digital. You have groups of friends on Telegram and Instagram and WhatsApp, and you just take the article, put a nice heading, some bullet points of what you liked about it and share it. And it goes out and then people let them debate and say, oh, if you don't like anything just help me at their mom, and let them come into our system inshaAllah and then they can be answered inshaAllah. Subhana rabbika rabbal izzati amma yasifoon, salaamun al mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ila sharafa nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alihi wa ashabihi kiram wa lama shaykhina fi tariqatina ashbandiyyata al aliyya wa sayyira wa saddatina wa sidiqina al fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations go. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input. And with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, NurMuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been providing basic necessities to those most in need worldwide. There have been over 600 water wells established in rural communities across Pakistan already. We continue to support and maintain multiple orphanages, providing a safe haven for hundreds of orphans, encouraging a pleasant environment for them to flourish. There are now multiple food vans operating across many cities worldwide, with our many volunteers ensuring the needs of the most vulnerable are met. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings and go to MuslimCharity.com.